Okay.
We're live.
Yeah, we're live.
Hi, Daya. I don't know where
I feel very weird. My hand is on the right, but it is on the left.
I'm not able to compute this.
We should have done this on Zoom only, you know, comments tab.
My hand is on the right, but it is on the left.
Oh, somebody is saying hello, we are waiting.
Why is... Oh.
Manish is giving hearts. Hi, Manish. Hearts to you also.
Hello.
Hi, Pukraj.
Just stop waiting. We are here. My mother is here, guys.
Okay, can we introduce and start?
Yes, let's do this. Vivek has actual things to do.
No. My favorite comedy quartet. We are not comedy quartet.
We are All India Book Chod.
I got a Bumble notification. Hold on.
Hello everybody, welcome to this YouTube live from StreamYard. We are now ducking inside. Never mind. Okay, we are here to talk to you guys. My name is Sharon. I'm Book Mohatarma. On my left, actually on my right is...
On your right only. She's on your right, she is.
Guys!
On this side.
Guys!
On my right is Anuya.
On your below me is Anuya.
Yes. Above me is Smriti.
And
above
then on my Smriti. Left is Smriti, who is Santreets. And below Smriti Santreets is Vivek Tejuja, jo hai nahi tuteja. Okay.
Correct.
We are if you're new to the Books on Toast channel, don't be alarmed. This is just how we are. We love talking about books and we have too much patience. And so our passion comes out like this only sometimes. We're very nervous and just like randomly excited people. But Smriti Santreets is a YouTuber who talks about books and it's a booktuber hence. Vivek Tejuja is an author and his new book is coming out in December. Correct, Vivek?
January, which none of these girls are going to read. I was going to say something else.
Oh my God!
But it is okay. That ship has sailed clearly or not. But it is okay moving on.
Yes, but we'll promote it on this channel. So, you know, for that sake, at least you can stop whining, Vivek.
No. Never. Meri book aisi hai jisko kabhi award ke liye nominate nahi kiya jata hai.
On that note, this is the topic of the discussion. We are talking about bookish awards and what does that really mean to us readers? Does it impact our choices? Are there any fun books that we've read that are award winning? So yeah, so that's the mm-hmm. topic. So our first question to all of you, and I would really like to go in a clockwise manner. We'll start with Vivek.
I'll just say who first.
Yeah.
We'll go to Vivek, Smriti, then Anuya, and then me. Ah. I don't know what this is, some geometric formation. But Vivek,
the first question is, Smriti, what is the first question? It is this.
Do we read
books that are long listed for prizes?
Yes, sir.
Do we read also? Yes. We read also.
Amya is scolding me. Okay. Yes, Vivek, please answer this question.
What? Do I read books that are long listed? Of course, all the time. I read long lists of most prizes that come out and I love doing that.
And which is the latest one that you have read and what are your feelings about?
So I'm actually about to read The Promise by Damon Galgut. I finished reading A Town Called Solace by Mary Lawson, which I absolutely loved. And just not a diversion, but just talking like this year's Booker, the last couple of years also, Booker seems very, very accessible than how it used to be in the past. So, and I love reading long listed titles for prizes, especially prizes that are not known, right? Like there's a prize called Lambda, which is for the queer community. It's that diverse. It has about 25 to 30 categories that range from LGBTQINA, which is, they don't only have fiction, but they also have non-fiction, graphic novels, memoirs. And within those categories, there are long-listed books and short-listed books, which is very, very interesting, right? They have trans narratives and queer narratives and lesbian, bisexual, gay. So I think these prizes have helped me discover so many new books. And prizes that are diverse, not just the typical white men or white lady prizes that were, that was the case earlier. But now that is also changing. So yeah, I read long-listed titles for prizes for sure. And I love that.
I have heard that this year's booker is its most diverse ever.
Very diverse.
Last year also was quite diverse.
Last year was Pelle also. Remember when you read Snap, Anuya, and that graphic novel was there, Sabrina.
That was 2 years ago.
Yeah. When Sharon and I read all the, I mean, we attempted it, and then after that year we gave up. We were like, nahi, nahi hota.
That is the year I discovered Valerie Louise Ellie. I think that was 2019 only.
Yeah. The Lost Children Archive.
That was a fucking fantastic book. And Booker to jaake fuck slave for not putting it in the shortlist.
Yeah, I
know. Oh, no. Bookers.
And because of that book, I also read her other book, which was
Tell Me How It Ends.
No, something about teeth.
Yeah, The Story of My Teeth.
That was also very fascinating. I would have not known about her had it not been for the book long list. So, but yeah. But usko dala nahi shortlist mein, which was very heartbreaking. Yeah, thanks. Okay. Good to know you have feelings about very nice awards. What about you, Smriti Sant? What are your feelings?
So I keep a lookout for all the awards. Also, like as Vivek said, like the Lambda National Book Award in the US. Because there are a lot, like even there's like the Bailey Guilford Award, which is going to come now in like, which is nonfiction books and all of that. Because I think it's interesting to like just have an understanding of like, these are the options which are available. In terms of the long list, I'm like, I know there are a lot of people who like Vivek, who want to read the entire long list and see which one is good for shortlist and all of that. That I don't think I have like patience for, to be honest. Though what I do is I do look at the long list and then go like, what out of these do I think are interesting, and then like read whatever I want to. Because if I go into this thing of like wanting to read the entire long list of every award that I think is interesting, then I'm fucked. Like I don't have time for that. So yeah, like that's basically where I go. In terms of like, so for example, what I'm doing now is I'm reading the shortlist for the Women's Prize. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I really like the jury. Like I've looked at the jury, like the jury is headed by Bernardine Evaristo, and I really like what they've had to say and all of that. So yeah. I'm like, I trust your shortlist. Like, at least, if not for your long list, I will definitely read your shortlist. And I think I've read 3 of the shortlist and I've loved all of them. Like, all of them are above 4.
Which ones?
I have read Piranesi.
Suzanne Clark.
Cherry Jones, you read
Yeah. Jones. How the One-Armed Sleeps the House. And I've read Transcendent Kingdom by Yajas.
Didn't like Transcendent Kingdom at all. I would give it a 2.
I think a lot of people didn't like Transcendent Kingdom because they didn't like a lot of people told me like, oh, Transcendent Kingdom's not good. So I went in with very lowered expectations. But
like I love Homegoing, right?
Sorry. Yeah, I haven't read Homegoing either.
Yeah.
So,
you must read Homegoing.
Yeah, exactly. I think it worked for me because I hadn't read Homegoing. A lot of people read Homegoing and thought that this book was going to be on the same level, and apparently it wasn't. And because I didn't know what that level was, I was like, this.
You were not let down.
Ha, correct. And also, like, everyone was like, it's not that great. So I was like, chalo, try kar lete, dekhte. But I really liked it. I liked the things that they were discussing, and they were talking about addiction and religion versus science and like a lot of things. So I was like, this is actually really, really interesting. And I also read the audiobook as well, for the audiobook of it, which of this one.
Transcendent Kingdom.
Yeah. Okay. So it, like, I felt like it went faster for me as well, and I really like enjoyed that experience of like being able to like listen to this person tell me the story as well. So yeah, so like those are, so like I go and I don't necessarily read all of the long listed books, if that's like the answer to your question, but I do like check them all out. Like there's a BookTube prize also, if you didn't know.
Oh,
so yeah, wow. Interesting. So there's this thing called BookTube prize where people like they can sign up to be judges. So BookTubers can sign up to be judges, and then they give you like a list, and then it's basically like you put your vote in, and there's like semi-finals and whatever. It's really interesting. And then like basically it's like the BookTube community as a whole decides a prize. So
wow,
you should be part of this, I think.
It's very cool.
They give a tube made of books. That should be the award. Just like
just a tube.
I'm sorry, I'm very tired, guys.
Vikray, you're tired. I can see.
Harami.
But I would like
to from your jokes that you're tired, Anuya.
Yes. I would like to add, though, from to Smriti's points, that I think amongst the Booker, the Pulitzer, I think the Women's Prize has been consistently rewarding us readers with like really good books that have been like, I read Home Fire because it was, you know, that's where I found out about it. That was, I think, the 2017 shortlist. Mm. Though that book lost to Tayari James Ka America, whatever. Yes. And then, of course, like, I mean, Madeline Miller's Circe, which we talk about a lot on this channel, was also shortlisted. Then, of course, Bernardine Evaristo's Girl, Woman, Other, which, of course, won the Booker as well, was shortlisted. I mean, just, and then, of course, this Pat Barker, The Silence of the Girls, that was shortlisted a few years ago as well. Naomi Alderman's The Power was shortlisted as well. So, consistently, I feel like the Women's Prize ka shortlist is much more accessible, I find, than most other awards ke longlist and shortlist. So, I mean, that's winning in my heart as well.
Yeah.
That's what I thought when I picked up Transcendent Kingdom. It was very boring.
very badly written.
I liked it.
Are you sure it's the same person who's written Homegoing? Or is it a different person who's written the book?
Yeah. Which I also love. I loved Homegoing. I think that's the problem also. She wrote a very depressing book post-Homegoing. Not that Homegoing wasn't depressing also, but there was a certain amount of pace, you know, to the book and sense of adventure. Whereas Transcendent Kingdom just was like, meh, throughout.
But
like,
Homegoing's theme was also lovely, no? When we're looking at every generation of the same family.
Yeah. And the best thing about Homegoing for me was how I never really thought of the African people complicit in slave trade. I never really thought of them. So, you know, it really opens your eyes to a lot of things. So, yeah, so compared to that, Transcendent Kingdom is very pukkau. I left it after two chapters. I was like, nahi.
No.
Zindagi mein bahut dukh hai. Kitab mein bhi dukh nahi chahiye.
But lekin ye bhi hai ki Homegoing, surprisingly, though we loved it, was not on any long list or short list of any popular awards in that sense. I mean, I didn't discover it through an award. Now that I think of it.
Shortlisted for Homegoing, actually, which is like so do you think that she's actually shortlisted for her work on the Homegoing? It's like in retrospect.
Leonardo DiCaprio won for Revenant.
But if Transcendent Kingdom wins, I'm going to go and do dharna outside their house. wherever they are. Bloody hell. Stupid book, yeah. Sorry. What book was that?
It is stupid.
Listen. Haan, so it is your perspective. I'm not saying.
But I tell you, it reminded me a lot of M and the Big Home for some reason. Because of the whole depression, mother.
M and the Big Home, but Bandra and Mahim mein nahi kidhar aur.
Ha, correct.
Okay. It's my turn now. I'll talk now.
Talk.
Do I read books that are long listed for prizes? No.
That was short.
I studiously and steadfastly avoid them unless they are recommended to me by another source that I trust. And the reason for all of this is Arundhati Roy's.
I will fucking come and stab you in your house. I swear it, Anuja Jakarta. One word against God of all things, and I swear I'm going to leave this channel. Whatever.
When I was very young, I read a book called God of Small Things because it won the Booker, and it was so complicated and sad and depressing, and nothing good ever happened. It was so relentless, and I had to read everything 15 times to understand what the fuck she was trying to say. And in the end, it was brother sister doing sex.
Anuja, at what age did you read the book?
I was very young. The year it won, I think maybe the year after that.
Yeah, 97. Yeah. My point is, abhi usko 20 saal se upar ho gaya hai.
Nahi padhna mere ko.
No, now nahi to mujhe se padhna padega ye book. Mere saath padhna padega.
Nahi padhungi main. Nahi. And that is when I realized, oh my God, these Booker Prize winning books are really boring.
You are going to read God of Small Things with me again. You're going to start in September. You're going to finish
no,
it.
No, I'm not.
Yes, yes.
Let's do one thing.
Whoever wants Anuja to reread God of Small Things, in the comments say yes, Vivek and Anuja, and we'll count the number of people. If there are more than 10 people who want Anuja to reread God of Small Things, Anuja is going to reread God of Small Things. Just say yes, Vivek, in comments and do it right now.
Yes, yes. I do not agree.
Yes.
Yeah, even
okay, moving on.
I just want to say that I realized today while we were, when we decided to do this, that unintentionally, a lot of my favorite books are Pulitzer Prize winners. So they are doing something.
Two people have said yes, Vivek. Six people have said yes, Vivek. I'm the same. Ten people.
No, I am not doing this. No, thank you, yes. Nala Das.
This Nala thank Das you. Doesn't have Nala. Keep quiet.
Vivek, this, don't diss our audience. Ek to kam log hai. Okay, let's move on. Come on.
But people are saying yes, Vivek. Anuja is going to reread God of All Things. Yes. Yes.
Sharon, please yes. Do something.
Yay! My mom is supporting you silently in the comment section. Like, who wants to read morbid? Mama, it's not too morbid. I will read this with you also. Don't worry, I'm coming tomorrow.
Thanks, auntie.
The tyranny of majority.
Tyranny of majority. You please keep quiet.
I
just want to take a moment to appreciate Pokhraj, who is, I think, the best, one of the most steadfast sort of fan friends that we've had on this channel for such a long time. He's amazing. Love you.
Yes.
Love
just
you, buddy.
Just because he tells you not to read God of All Things, amazing.
Well, very that's good. A bonus.
Your reading taste is questionable.
Oh, no, I got the end of
But listen, okay. There's a good question I want to talk about. Somebody asked in the comment section, if you're okay with that. There's this guy called Shahzad who said, our award winning, where did it go in all the hi, hello, puppy, puppy, where does that question go? Oh, Shahbaz said, our award winning books accessible for beginners?
That's a great question.
Yeah.
Booker, yeah. For sure, not really. But the Women Prize for sure is very accessible to beginners.
Dekho, paisa mil raha hai, Women's Prize for fiction.
No, I just looked at the look at the Booker selection. Hamesha, it's like most of those books, you just like get so turned off by reading them. Like, I'll tell you what, like, if we can talk about the shittiest award winning or long listed books that we have read, one of the few ones that I just finished reading is The China Room by Sanjeev Sahota.
Oh no,
but I liked it, Shannon. Mujhe bahut acha
laga.
Mujhe sach mein achhi lagi. Okay. No, I thought really, it was very
it's
good.
It's about an addict. That's it. And then
no, it's not
the
it was Meher's story. It wasn't the addict story. But you're not talking about the book. You're talking about the prizes.
What is the question? Sorry.
Award-winning book accessible for beginners.
Acha, no, they're not. No.
I would say.
Some of them are accessible.
You have to look, like, do a litmus test. Like, go and see what people are saying. all of that sort of that, like, it there's no like a this award is a friendly, beginner friendly award reading long list that is not going to happen, but a lot of them are. So for example, the Booker Prize used to be very hard to read, but now it's become very accessible. So like, I don't know.
It depends. I think for me, if I read the first page, the first two pages, and the pace is easy and I'm able to continue reading, so that then it's accessible, right? Like then that means that that book is like, you know, calling out to you. And so always like download a sample. Don't buy the whole book on Kindle if you're doing that. Read like a few pages and you'll be like, okay, this is for me or not. You know, you'll be able to make that decision fairly quickly. Having said that, yes, Booker Prizes have been trying to include some diverse and easy books, like Normal People, for instance, which Amya has clearly pointed out in the comment section, was pretty easy. It was to read.
That and crime book that we read, the Snap, no? That was also very easy.
Well, yeah. Exactly. So, I mean, there is a concerted effort being made by juries, and I think it all depends on juries, right? If there are people who have evolved reading choices, and if they are from diverse backgrounds and not really academic and literary backgrounds, they'll more likely to pick up books that are more accessible in general. So for sure, right? But tell me something, guys, like coming to my next question, what are some of the good books that you have discovered because they were mentioned in book prizes?
I think my number one, which I always like think of, is All the Light We Cannot See by Anthony Doerr. This was a book that I picked up because it won the Pulitzer. Like I was like, I wasn't really in that phase of like reading at that point of time. And I think like I'm very grateful to that book because it got me back to historical fiction. Like I'd forgotten what historical fiction and like how much I loved it, and it really got me back to it. So like it won the Pulitzer, I was like, chalo, let's see what it is, and I loved it. So that is my first thing which I will always remember. Yeah.
Okay, great. That's let's just stick to one book recommendation, otherwise I think we'll have many. So Vivek, yeah, come on, one book that you were very like because you picked up as a, yeah, maybe you answer a more diverse question. Come on. Like what award-winning book you picked up that you really loved, which really surprised you?
I think when I started reading graphic novels, it was in Mouse, and that was way back in 2001. And that is because it won the Pulitzer Prize, I think, or it won the National Book Award, one of the two. And that I thought was very, very impactful because that was my entry into graphic novels in that sense. So I think if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't have picked up any graphic novel. As in, I would have picked them up later than earlier. So, yeah.
That's a great answer. Anuya?
Anuya, I I'm going to name two books because I break rules.
No, choose one.
And Rebel.
Big one. Okay,
no, they are interconnected. So, I have recently finished reading a book that Smriti loves, and Smriti, why you love sad books so much? called which Vivek also loves, called A Little Life.
Oh,
ooh, love it, love it, love it.
Yeah, by Hanya Yanagihara. I never get it right. Yeah, I was just like, and then anyway, I'm sorry, that is very offensive, so I shouldn't do that. It's just, it's a hard name, and I'm stupid. So that book, everybody told me it'll break you, break you, break you. But still, I was like, itna bhi kya bura ho sakta hai? But it is. Ho sakta hai, itna pura. So even though a lot of it feels like grief porn and suffering porn, you know, just like, I don't know how she does it, but she stops it from being full-blown melodrama, which I think is a rare feat. It could have very easily become Daniel Steele, and it doesn't. And that's because of the writing and the storytelling and the talent in both those things, right? So that book I read and I listened to, and because it is such a hard book to read, I thought it'd be easy to listen to it, but it doesn't. It you feel it more deeply when you are listening to that book, which is a good thing and a bad thing. When I was reading it, I was pacing, I was racing through it because I wanted to know what was going to happen next. But when I was listening to it, I could focus on the language. So yeah, I think that's the book, because it is so fresh in my mind. I literally finished it 2 days ago. I would say that book really surprised me, because I thought it would be one of those like hard to read, you know, obscure book, shortlisted books, but it's surprisingly not. And I mean, it will really destroy you. Like I was in a public place when I was reading, so I tried not to cry in the end. But it's such a frustrating.
Oh my God.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's very frustrating. God. Yeah, just like heartbreaking. But the reason why I said two books, because the other book that was also like this was The Goldfinch, which I picked up with no expectation, and just because it won the Pulitzer Prize. And both books are New York, both books are art, you know, there's a, so I think both these books are my favorite award-winning books, that I just, that surprised me by how taken I was with them. Like I didn't think they would affect me so much, but they did. I really want to watch the Goldfinch movie, but I'm afraid.
Don't watch it. It's very bad.
I'm scared of what will happen.
Algot.
Ah,
is it about the Goldfinch?
What?
Move on, Sharon. Bad book. Moving on, Sharon. It is a bad book. It is a book. Sylvie doesn't like it. It is a book. I tell you, wo middle of the book, wo bachcha, wo ma, main tang aa gaya. I mean, so much.
I was how pissed off with the end.
Much.
Okay, the last.
I trudged around the last 50 pages are fine.
Last
yes,
50 pages? Yeah, I agree. It should have been edited. And then I was already too much in love. Sorry.
Main, I was like, kitna zarurat hai ye? Tumne kitab padhi nahi edit karne ke liye? What the fuck is going on? You know, that's my reaction to The Gold.
I like
because, it. Anya, don't get me wrong. I love The Secret History, right? I think that's a great book.
I think it's perfect. The Secret History is perfect.
And even the number of pages, even the tone from start to finish is brilliant.
Yeah.
But after that, I read The Little Friend. I was like, oh, Little Friend, leke mujhe maar do book ke saath.
I didn't read it only. I couldn't finish Little Friend.
And
I
couldn't finish.
And it's so like, you can get like murdered by
Goldfinch. Goldfinch also.
I actually bought the fucking US edition, you know, of Goldfinch. Hardcover costed me a bomb. God.
I bought Goldfinch at an airport and I left it in the plane and then I bought it again on my Kindle and I read
it.
No, I liked it. By the way, guys, all the audiobooks that we are talking about, there's a link in our description to Storytel. All of them, all the audiobooks that we've heard on Storytel. So if you want to check it out, please go check it out. It's always nice to reach out to our sponsors so that we keep getting money and we are able to make more videos. Thank you.
Yes, thanks.
Yeah.
But can I tell you about one book that I feel I manifested its journey in this world? And I don't know why I feel proud for it, because I didn't do anything, but because I had discovered it in an audiobook format, which is very unlikely. And then it took the journey it did. It became my journey, okay? So this is how, like, as readers, you feel so connected to a novel, right? So I heard The Far Field as an audiobook first.
Yeah.
And this was when it wasn't even in India. It was released in Groove Atlantic, I think that was the original publisher.
Groove Atlantic, correct.
And uski ek audiobook maine waisi, I was just, you know, like going through Storytel and just randomly I clicked on it because the cover is beautiful. I clicked on it and then the first line, I still remember, the narrator said, my name is Shalini, I am 30 years old and it is nothing. Something about that line gripped me and I could not stop. Like, I heard that book. It was a really long book to hear because audiobooks take time, right? It's an investment. I heard that book over like a period of 3 to 4 days, mostly while, you know, just going through traffic in and out of office to work, etc. in Bombay. And I would look forward to that experience and it was okay. The pace was slow while I was listening to that book, but it was okay. It wasn't one of those books where, you know, you really wanted to read what happened next. You would like because it's the story of a woman who is making a journey of her own self-discovery and you don't like the choices she makes, because these are the choices generally male protagonists make, you know, in novels, and they get away with it. It's okay. But because a woman is making this choice, something about her choices makes you not like her. And she, it's her voice that you hear, right, in the audiobook. And I loved it because she took this journey. She went to Kashmir looking for somebody who could help her figure out her relationship with the mother. And Kashmir just comes alive. Its politics come alive. And it sort of gives you that idea of how you are a person outside of the experience living in urban city. No idea what's going on in Kashmir, but something in you makes you want to empathize with it and understand it. But it feels so distant. So I heard it. It changed me. Something about it changed me. Then I found that the book was, you know, going to be released in India. And I know that Vivek, you had also interviewed Madhuri Vijay.
Yeah.
So I read that book. And then the next thing you know, it was longlisted for the JCB brand.
Yeah,
and then I kept thinking that, you know, theek hai, it is, you know, this was the second round of the JCB prize. And I thought that maybe for diversity, they have put it. But it seems so unlikely that it will win. And it won.
Yeah.
Good.
As like, it I should have.
There was no other choice candidate. Fun fact, we were at the ceremony when the prize was being awarded, and our vibes, no, Johan, our videographer and editor, he was like, main jaake room mein so raha hai, mere ko nahi dekhna prize ceremony. So he fucked off, and these guys, thinking that everybody would be down at the award function, put all the winning, they put winning copy of the book in everybody's rooms. And that was far field. Yeah. And he took a photo and he's like, Sharon, dekh, teri wali jeet gayi.
And all Anuya, Sharon and I sitting on different tables, okay? And just getting this group chat, and like all of us suddenly like look at each other going like, what?
We can't say moment. Okay, this was our Olympics chuck day moment. It felt like we won. Though we didn't do anything, but we won.
It was great.
We were talking about the books, our favorite award winning books is what we were talking about.
It's and your turn. Next question.
Yeah. Next book question is, we have, I think, already answered it in many ways, but I was going to ask, what are the shittiest award winning books
you have read? I want to talk about it. Ask. Please ask.
Please, like, look at this. Please say na now. You are.
This, you remember the first JCB prize? The first JCB prize, you remember?
My t-shirt says everything at this point.
There was this book called Empire by Yashodhara Devi, you remember? Long listed. Yes. The corresponding years also there were many. I have not stopped. So that was one. Then, of course, you have the winner of the first year, Jasmine Lace, which Anuya and I both didn't like very much. And we've spoken about it on Books on Toast also. Remember, Anuya, when we did that reading and we spoke about Jasmine Lace? Sorry. I have to talk, guys. Elephant in the room, what to do?
We had to be very politically correct. So we couldn't say
that time we were working with them. So, but we were all very disappointed.
No. And then you remember
other books that were so good in that shortlist. Attitudes of Longing.
And then there was Clouds. Then there was Clouds by
Clouds.
Chandrahas Chaudhary. Then there was the book of what was that? Chocolate Sings by Jerry Pinto.
Jeet Thai.
That was the second one, I think.
Oh God, I was like, "Inko headache kyun de raha hai 10 page ke andar?" I agree.
But can I tell you the worst book that I have read, which is award winning, is White Tiger.
Oh, that was so bad.
I was like, what the fuck is this? It is we are basically just saying that the servant will kill the master always. It's like a very strange Freudian shit, and it is.
वो movie तो चूतिया है, book तो उससे ज़्यादा बड़ा चूतिया है.
But the book is written in this colloquial like syntax, right? Which is bad grammar, bad English, bad Hindi. मतलब editor को hire ही मत करो, उसको पैसे ही मत दो. फिर भी हम उसको booker दे देंगे और उसकी movie भी बना देंगे. I don't know anybody who has seen that movie liked it. I don't know anybody who's read that book and liked it. Yet it is award winning, which I don't understand. I really don't.
ये तभी you know Anuya, what was happening? Sharon, sorry. This was token Indian writer को जब भी वो Vernon God Little, another book award winner.
Oh my God, I have tried to read that book so many times. I've tried to read it
again.
I've never been able to read it. Just it's unreadable. I don't know what it is. It's like someone took Catcher in the Rye and you know fucked it with. What is happening? It's the one about the shooting, right? The kid who wants to shoot people.
Yeah.
School shooting.
Vernon God Little by D.B.C. Pierre.
Yeah. I think it won the year after Life of Pi, so my expectations were very high from Booker. I was like, oh, now I like award-winning books. And
Don't get me started about Life of Pi. Moving on.
Don't shit on Life of Pi.
I'll tell you. Okay, it's so only the first part of Life of Pi is where it should have ended. That book should have ended there.
I don't think
he should have ever come back to Unland. The tiger is seeing him. There's some hallucination experience. There's something going on. The tiger is going away.
There are trees eating him and all that. Yeah.
I love the philosophy. Don't get me wrong. But the book.
I loved it. Yeah, it was a little strange. But yeah, I loved it. No, yeah.
It's not about strange. It was just, it didn't deserve the Booker Prize. It didn't deserve to be in the shortlist. Longlist, I can understand. And then there was Testaments. Okay, let's not talk about that.
Testaments. Do not shit on Testaments. It didn't win. Did it deserve to win a Booker? No, not at all. I like the book. Yeah, it's not a bad book. I enjoyed it. I just didn't feel that it was award worthy, but. ठीक है बहुत सारी नॉन अवार्ड वर्दी चीजों एटलीस्ट आई कुड रीड इट लेट्स जस्ट लाइक दैट्स द बेस्ट आई रेड इट एंड आई इट एंटरटेन्ड मी सो एटलीस्ट देयर वाज दैट
दैट्स बिकॉज़ द बुक इट फेल्ट लाइक इट वाज मोर ऑफ अ सीक्वल फॉर द टीवी सीरीज रादर देन लाइक द बुक इटसेल्फ लाइक इट वाज इट फेल्ट लाइक दैट एंड आई
बट यू नो व्हाट आई डिडंट लव हैंडमेड्स टेल आई डिडंट लव इट आई थॉट इट वाज गुड इट वाज ओके I felt like Testaments was a more palatable, more sort of less confusing version of Handmaid's Tale. Like, I feel like she wrote it with a commercial sort of, you know, endeavor in mind. And you could see it. Like, she was not writing to make, like, waves in the literary world. Oh, ho gaya. That is also Revenant ke liye prize dena hai, Margaret Atwood ko.
Okay. Yeah.
Booker of Bookers.
Yeah.
Weren't you guys slightly outraged last year when Girl, Woman, Other had to share this prize with another book? I felt like it was good enough to have done it. You know, it was really, really good.
There's this whole thing which the chairman of the jury
Bookers.
Was the one who was pushing for it, and everyone else was like, "Nahi kar yaar, it's not that great." But the chairman was like, "Nahi, Atwood ko hi milega."
Oh,
it was one
internal politics.
Correct. Even the prize was like no, but the chairman was like nay.
Guys, anyone else think Booker is a great dating app idea for people who like to read? Like,
oh, I like this idea.
You turn the page if you like the person.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Next page.
And if you're reading, and if you're reading Dune, that is also won an award. Then I'm going to left swipe you because
Yeah, Dune is not bad, but Dune is very outdated. It's very
Please,
outdated.
Can I talk about my shittiest book that has been long listed? I already did. No.
Smriti also has to talk, no?
Smriti also has to. Actually, I know Smriti, so for
yeah,
Smriti.
It's right here.
Oh my god, no Smriti.
I hated it so much. I tried so hard.
मुझे मेरी दवा लेनी पड़ेगी so that I don't get a heart attack because of
How does anyone read that book? You need
that was also tokenism, guys. I really think that it didn't deserve to win, but it was tokenism.
See, I agree to some extent, but I also feel that if you sit with the book without any distraction and only read Mustache and don't read anything else alongside, you might immerse yourself in the book.
That was me. I did that for so. I tried three times. Three times I did this. Three times.
Okay, when they make a web series, a Netflix series out of it, you watch it.
Oh my god. They'll have to spend 1 year just trying to understand what is going on. Okay. That book should come with a codex. Ki how to decipher what's written. Like, you know,
I would love to see this web series because I want to see how the Mustache becomes goat.
Honestly, I would not.
It's becoming a boat, actually. Because, you know, you take it there and then you put
it on. Listen, I don't want to argue with you guys because to each their own, really. I completely get it why people didn't like it. I think the majority didn't like it. So, I get it completely. I understand why. So, it's okay.
But that's the fun about these awards, I think. Like, look at the JCB prize. It's been around for 3 years. The first book that won was Jasmine Days, when Latitudes of Longing and Half the Night is Gone were in the list.
Running.
And Jasmine Days won. And that was the one book I hadn't read. And I read it after it won. And I was like, what? I'm angry. But the next year, Farfield won. Which was clearly everybody's favorite.
Surprising.
Yeah. And then the year after which is, I think, craft-wise, yes, I think there was a lot there to mine. You know, like, I'm sure it's, you have to recognize it for what it was doing, but it was just so, so inaccessible that
agree that instead of that, these are bodies possessed by light should have won the award hands down. Dharani deserved it way better. Okay, I know. ये हम लोग का चलता रहेगा ना पूरा टाइम. हम लोग को पसंद आएगी, दो लोगों को पसंद नहीं आएगी. I agree with Riya. The Inheritance of Loss is junk. Yes, it is.
That's the other one I tried after Arundhati Roy. Oh my God.
That was quite bad.
Loved the women's prize so much, and so do I, but I could not read Hamnet. I read 60% of it and I gave up. That's a record.
Hilary
Mantel didn't write that book. Hamnet is
Maggie
not
O'Farrell.
Maggie O'Farrell. And it's Shakespeare's son's death. And tumko lagega, are mar raha hai, to matlab kuch to exciting hoga. Why is nothing happening? Maybe I am wrong.
Sometimes I agree with Anuya, and this is one of the times. Whenever a novel ke upar likha hota hai na, luminous, magnificent, epic, I run away from such books because I'm like, oh God, this luminous prose, I'm not going to understand.
Well, you didn't like Hamnet? Please tell me more.
Listen, I'll tell you. I liked Hamlet, but I'll tell you what I didn't like about Hamlet. Like she said, Anuya, nothing is happening. See, I love the writing. For me, if the writing is beautiful, I'll forgive you. I'll be like, chal, theek hai. On the other hand, if the writing is not so beautiful, like what was that book that I disagreed on with you? I don't remember.
Goldfinch.
Yes, Goldfinch. Sorry. Where the writing is not very good, I will be like, what did I do? What is this? Actually, the writing should be good, not like the God of Small Things. Writing is good.
Get to the point.
You know,
also good story. The point is Hamlet ka writing bahut acha tha.
Haan,
but should I won the award for the writing? No. Should I won the award for the plot as well? Yes, I agree.
Yeah, anyway, I just felt very let down.
Let's wrap this up by the last question that I want to ask all of you. Now that you guys have picked up so many books and there are so many books you guys like and so many books clearly you do not like, what is the problem with book awards today? Let's start with you, Vivek, as guys, token author that, in this token discussion.
Before I start with that, can we just acknowledge one thing about, we've not spoken about the Sahitya Academy Award, which I want to talk about.
Okay, yes, yes.
Especially because it is homebred and since 1960, people have been receiving it. So I think it also covers all languages. So just a shout out to the Sahitya Academy Award. That go to their Wikipedia page, especially for English titles.
Hmm.
Go and see the alternate title that should win prizes like JCB but never get nominated for prizes like JCB. So I think that's a good way to discover Indian literature as well. Hana, also, sorry,
so
your
many
question. So many translations. Yeah,
like in whatever language you want. They have an award for that. Great.
Yeah.
You know, the UA Award is very nice. Is a very good way to discover young, up and coming, interesting novelists across languages. But you know what? I think you should. Yeah, you're right, Sharon. Please, your question, please.
Sorry, Sharon. What is your question?
What is the problem? No, it's a good. It's a good. Good shout out. I think the Shadow Lines by Amitav Ghosh was a great like that won him the Sahitya Academy Award. It was also very good.
Yeah.
Okay. So. Problems with book awards. What is the biggest?
So I think the biggest problem with book awards is that publishers honestly only push their front list or the books that they want the awards to be longlisted or shortlisted for or eventually win so that those books sell. I think inherently the problem is also with the publishing side and the marketing side of publishing houses because I feel the books that are not spoken about or don't get the spotlight are the ones that lose out. But thankfully today with so many social media platforms, those books are also get talked about like on Bookstagram or BookTube or Twitter or Facebook or wherever, right? Even Clubhouse now. So I think that is changing, but it's a slow process. But I think publishers should also be extremely mindful about what they are pushing. Only big names need not win awards. Don't need another Arundhati Roy to win another award. It's okay. If the book is great, please, by all means, do that. But there can be a Mary Lawson that appears on the long list and perhaps even wins. Or even a Damon Galgut that nobody's perhaps heard of or most people haven't heard of. But I think that is very, very important. That but who will tell? Who will bell the cat? Nobody knows that they have to do it. So I think that's my point on this.
That's a good point. Smriti, do you have a point of view?
I think for me, like it's not an issue per se, but it's just something that I've come to realize over the years is that the awards, the reason why they change so much and that you can't predict them is because it's a jury that predicts them and the jury changes every year. So you need to, like, for example, with the JCB also, we've seen how the jury has changed and how they, like, they have their own reasons, for example, for choosing Jasmine Days or, like, for the mustache or whatever, which we can't really, like, predict per se. So the people who chose the far field, very different from the people who chose mustache. So that's one thing which I am more, like, careful of now when I start, like, when I try to read books that are long-listed or short-listed, then I go and see what the jury has to say and what they are like also. So, like, that is something, like, that's why I said, right? Like, that's why I'm reading the Women's Prize shortlist. Because I've gone and seen, like, Bonnet and Everly Snow, yeah, she's the chairman of the jury. I like what she has to say. I like what the other people also on the jury have had to say, because they have those videos where they talk about, like, they do that whole thing, interviews and all of that. So I go and do a little bit of research on that, and then I see whether I agree with what they are saying and what they are striving for, and then, like, accordingly see, like, what it is. But that's my biggest thing, that, like, it's humans who are changing every year. So you need to, like, just be aware of, like, what that is. So that is my thing. But yeah, I also agree with Vivek fully, 1000%. Also,
Publishers, jury.
Also, like, I feel like people have this thing of needing to put, like, one filler book sort of thing. Like, I don't understand.
Filler book as in?
Like a book that, like, I don't know why it was there. Like, for example, like Clara and the Sun, for example. Like, I think.
There we go again. Sharon, have you read Clara and the Sun? Please tell me you like.
No, I haven't read it yet.
I will only accept comments on Clara and the Sun if Sharon reads it, because I know she will like it. So please, Smithy, refrain.
Achha. Okay, I will read it tomorrow. I have a.
Don't read it. Life is short.
You keep quiet.
Life is short, buddy.
You reread God of Small Things, buddy, because people wanted to reread it.
It's
yeah.
not happening. I don't care.
Oh my God.
Who somebody gave 200 rupees?
He got a four on chat.
Mithali, you're so sweet.
Thanks, Mithali.
Thank you, Mithali.
Yes, guys, we have super chats now. Super chats are things where you can give us money. Although that feels so, like, cheap, right? Like, we're performing for them and they're like, yeah.
Bring it on.
Can I just say one thing? Amya Roy is my favorite, because normally people watch that filler book for me also.
Yes.
In 2018. A terrible book that normal people, terrible show that normal people.
No, the
and Sally the Rooney, beautiful world. To kidhar hai, beautiful world. Main idhar hu, meko nahi padhne ka. I don't want to read Beautiful World. Where are you? I don't want to read Conversations with Friends. I'm sorry. Very good. Okay, that is not my response to accurate. There's no accurate.
It really is. I think he's nailed it. That's, you keep quiet.
You keep quiet.
Pokhraj, tu chup ho ja, or tu bhi keep quiet.
Vivek's merch will be "You keep quiet" on it.
Yeah, keep quiet.
Oh my God, we need to make this. This is a Books on Toast t-shirt with "You keep quiet."
Whatever.
Anuya,
I'm unfollowing Pokhraj Roy from all the places that I follow.
Oh my God, that's his other response to criticism, by the way.
Delete his number. Everything
I don't have his number. Are you mad? Please.
I'm saying this is a general response.
Delete numbers. Correct.
Okay, God. How are we at 30 something?
What are your biggest issues?
Yeah.
My biggest issues, you guys have crystallized very nicely. Publishers are not sending maybe the right books forward, and juries need to be more diverse in their choices. But I feel like maybe one of the things that juries consistently don't do is look at books and then look at the commercial value of books. I feel like the moment a book has commercial value, it's automatically in the reject category for book prizes, which I don't understand. Like, I think we need to evolve from that perspective. Why can't a YA, why can't a fantasy, YA be long-listed or short-listed? Why not? Those are really, that's good literature. Like, of course, it's literary.
That is exactly.
They have their own awards now.
I know, but that's not the same. That is exactly what I was going to say.
Aise to Goodreads ke bhi prizes hain, which are pretty good, right?
Let's not even go there. Goodreads ke
prizes. No, I like Goodreads prizes. I discovered really nice books last year.
Yeah, but Anuya, please, I'm sorry. Ye Goodreads pe readers padte nahi hai, khali stars dekh ke chale jaate hain. Let it be. Wo bhi hota hai Goodreads pe.
Okay, but I enjoyed all the Goodreads picks.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, a lot of them are anyway are anyway the popular books that people are reading. So it's just like, you know, we can cement that.
Popular books, Midnight Library should never be nominated for any award.
It's a nice book, it's a good book to read in 2021, okay? Yeah. When you are like, I need something fluffy, nice, warm feelings. It's nice.
Very bad.
But anyway, my point is the same as Sharon's. I feel like people take themselves too seriously when they are judging these literary. Why does a book, a happy book will never win a literary award? See, now I know that Harry Potter is cancelled, but if we put that aside, okay, we take that, stick a pin in it. A book like Harry Potter, which has introduced an entire generation of girls and boys to reading, why is that not nominated for anything apart from what is that that award that they, Bloomsbury, Newsberry, whatever Berry award? Newbery Medal, yeah. Why is something like that not, you know, in the reckoning for a larger literary? Why is that not literature? Why does a book have to be difficult to read and inaccessible to people and serious and about the human condition? Yeah, human condition matlab ek hi hai kya? Ki we are just always like constantly questioning everything and the world and just feeling sad and depressed and like borderline, you know, suicidal and everything. This is not, why is that the human condition? Why is the human condition not joy and happiness and like hope? It's so look at all these books, yaar. They are so like, if it's happy, it'll not win. And that is something I disagree with. Or if it is in any way entertaining, then it'll not win. It can't be entertaining. It can't make you like, it can't be a page turner. It has to be. Why?
But Mary Lawson's A Town Called Solace is a page turner. I'm not even joking. Yeah. It is written very well. And Ashweta, thank you very much for loving my book. But that's not the point. But talk about Sharon and Amir, your thing. I feel, honestly, I also feel that because, Women's Prize for Fiction came into existence because there was 1 year in Booker where the shortlisted books were only male writers. They didn't include any women writers. So as a protest, Orange and the Women's Prize for Fiction, came up with that. At that time, I think it was Bailey's who used to sponsor, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, yes, it was the Bailey's sponsor.
And I think, so as evolution happens in terms of literature also, and when you see like Lambda is a great example, because I feel if LGBTQI folk aren't being represented enough by literary awards, or there are not enough literary awards for such writers, they're creating their own.
Yeah.
Fuck Booker and fuck all the white male privilege or whatever you may want to call it, or the other popular ones like Pulitzer or National Award, which is so American and British anyway, that it doesn't focus on country specific literature also. Only Arundhati Roy and an Arvind Dadiga could have won the Booker. I would have never seen Kiran Agarkar on that list. Why not? In spite of him being cancelled, that's not the point. But even author, right? I mean, there's so many other writers that are so good.
But that's
in the publisher's aspect. The publishers pushing plays a very big role, I think.
You know, surprisingly, the Pulitzer for me has been a discovery. Of course, they're all American, but they're all like the kind of diversity that I like. Jhumpa Lahiri, nobody had heard of before. Interpreter won the Pulitzer.
Yes.
Less is something I picked up because it won the Pulitzer. Then, I mean, Underground Railroad. So much of that's, I mean, I don't know how they're doing it. Maybe that's the one thing America's getting right about.
Yeah, Pulitzer. They are.
But the Pulitzer is really like nailing it sometimes. Yeah, at least.
They have good ones.
I trust the Pulitzer like
more than Booker. I trust Pulitzer.
Yeah.
The Pulitzer, right, has journalistic ideals.
That's why.
Journalistic ideals, right? So they always find contemporary new age writing, I think they value over dense stories.
Which is really something. I mean, I wish more people were like that, more juries were like that. But yeah, I think our winners, our book award that win are this is Pulitzer and Women's Prize very clearly.
Yeah.
These are the awards we give awards to.
Yes. Yeah. We give awards to Pulitzer and Women's Prize for Fiction. Good job.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
I was just going to say another thing which I like about the Women's Prize, which I wasn't aware of before this year, is that usually, you know how people, like the publishers, have to give these are the books that we nominate, blah, blah, blah. Whereas with the Women's Prize, what they can say is that we want this book also. Like, send us this book as well. Like, that is an option that they give
us.
Wow. Yeah, so that's one of the things that they do as well. Where it's not just based on, like, publishers are sending us these books. It's also the Women's Prize jury has the right to just be like, I also want this one to be nominated.
Yeah. I mean, why don't they do that why don't they ask viewers to send? Why can't readers send? Why do publishers send? Why don't they have just a submission form on their website where, you know, something someone has read? If it gets enough recommendations, for example, then take it. Take it and
do it. Jaise Indian Idol mein nahi hota hai ya whatever, like,
Don't equate, okay? Indian Idol mein koi bhi kar sakta hai. Idhar log kitab padh ke recommend karenge. It's already a lot of commitment.
They can, like, call in or, like, DM or whatever.
But that's also, like, I mean, like, you see that with the Goodreads Award, right? Like, for example, Stephen King will always win anything that he is there in because he is Stephen King. Like, if you see, generally, like, I did one little, like, deep dive last year or this year or whatever. Was that the amount of the amount of reviews that the book had got versus the amount of that the book had got. Like, the votes were more than the amount of people who had actually, like, read the book. So, like, what is that?
That's the internal bias, right? That's the writer bias.
But that is the fallout of everything.
That is
I just want to say that I'm currently listening to this book called Loveless, which won the YA Book Award. Yes, and it is about it's about a girl, I think, who is discovering that she's asexual. Like, I'm only halfway through. She hasn't, I mean, you kind of see it, but I'm enjoying it because, again, it's such a, it's a perspective into a mind that you are not privy to. So I'm really enjoying it. Because every young adult book is about romance and falling in love and this and that and blah, blah, blah. Whereas now here is a person who is just, who likes romance but is turned off by sex. And that is very fresh. I wonder what that's like. My life would have been so much better. If that was all the mistakes I made. Anyway.
Hello, Girish.
Girish ko frame mein leke aao. Where is Girish?
Girish.
So yeah, imagine. But guys, imagine that if we weren't all thinking with our genitalia, who would we be? Huh? Socho.
I don't even want to answer. I don't want to think about this. Moving on.
All right, Vivek has to go. He has a Bollywood quiz on Clubhouse, you guys.
I have time.
But I think we're done, no, Sharon?
Yeah, we're done.
I'm hungry, so we're done.
Okay, but thank you guys for watching. Thank you, Smriti and Vivek, as always, for joining and making this book.
Thank you for calling us.
Yes. Knit literary conversations with only Vivek and Smriti, nobody else. So one last time, guys, if you guys want to hear any of the audiobooks that we spoke about, please sign up to Storytel by clicking on the link in the description below. I know I've spoken about Far Field by Madhuri Vijay. And Anuya, what book did you talk about?
I spoke about A Little Life and Loveless.
Loveless. Loveless. Okay, cool.
Loveless.
Okay. Anuya, you have a killer smile.
One thing, by the way, I want to say hi, Shivang. Hi, Shivang Chopra. Hello.
And
Kunal Rana ne tumhe 100 rupees diye hain, guys. He said, I'm 20.
Kunal Rana, 100 rupees. Rana for reading. I hope you find more book recommendations by watching this video and add to your shelf of three novels.
Subscribe to Books on Toast. Watch more videos where I am there, where Smriti is there, where both of us are there, where we are not there. Just watch those videos and
we just thank you everybody for engaging with us on a Friday night. I mean, it's really something to take all this one, and I would not do it. So you know, everybody who does it. Say yeah, yeah, ghanta nikalte kisi ke bakwas suno.
Yeah, right. She's correct. Aditi, baad mein nahi karenge ye log. Ye nahi karenge.
Yeah, no. No, hey Aditi. Oh, you met
Aditi,
us.
Aditi, hi.
Yeah, I remember.
Yes.
हम लोग वो ग्रास पे बैठ के बुक्स
ग्रास पे बैठे थे
बीच में. Yes. Oh my God.
Nari celebrated my birthday in JLA, which was memorable for me.
Yes. Oh God.
And the I can't believe
at the rooftop restaurant. It's been 2 years.
Yeah.
And then we went to eat lal mas. Oh God.
Yeah. I can't believe it's been 2 years since that JLF. That JLF was so much fun.
That JLF.
And we were cribbing about the hotel rooms.
It was very bad. The hotel was horrible.
Guys, KLF.
Yeah. Next time. No, no.
KLF also JLF.
हमने हम हर जगह जाके होटल के होटल को गाली देते हैं.
और अपने पॉकेट से पैसे निकालते हैं.
Yeah. But it was worth it in KLF.
I think it
was a really nice hotel.
I think parting with that guy was the most fun. Like, what was his name?
Andrew.
I don't know.
About Smriti son, which I will not say here.
Guys.
But I have to say, guys.
Upset.
Okay. Part of JLF is this.
Upset to Vivek, very upset.
Yeah. Okay, anyway, part of JLF is this penguin party, okay, which is very lavish. Yeah, very lavish. Like, one carriage took us. Yeah. From door to like party. Ha, and there were candles and all of that was very nice. And we felt so out of place there that we pretended to be rich South Bombay people. And that is the most fun I've ever had at a party. I can't tell you. We were all like, oh my God, you too.
We started a dance party in the middle of the city. I don't know what happened. Yeah.
I swear.
Let's talk about what happened after the party. No?
These are things only for closed room discussions, not on internet.
Not in public forums?
Yes.
Forums? Okay. Chalo,
bye, guys. See you. Bye. This was fun.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Amya.